Alexander Malakov, and the concept of my thesis is to develop distributed approaches for power system state problems and make them work together, because I believe that in real life, ensemble is more effective than the standalone. So, why we are going distributed? On a high-level analysis, I can say that distributed energy resources are growing, and it means that microgeneration less than 5 megawatts, such as small CHPs, wind turbines, solar panels, are increasing their share in total installed capacity. It changes not only the topology of the system, logic of relay protection, and the capture flows and distribution networks, it also results into the shift of the whole paradigm. The distributed solution paradigm can augment existing centralized one by paying more attention to microgeneration. Furthermore, the data privacy and cybersecurity is better in distributed solutions, and I want to add that the system becomes more robust to more functions of the computational units and data channels. As the decentralized and distributed solutions is very hot topic nowadays, I want to denote my understanding. Centralized solution is when all the nodes are connected to the central ones and it is the only one computational unit. In decentralized solution, all the nodes are separated onto areas and every area has the central one computational unit. These computational units are communicating with each other in order to solve the problem. Distributed solutions do not have centers at all, and every node is the standalone computational unit, which are communicated with the immediate neighbors. There are different solutions for various power systems problems, such as optimal power flows, state estimation, frequency control, and market. But the scope of my thesis is to take two of them, the optimal power flow and state estimation, and make them work together. Let me start from the first algorithm, which is the power system state estimation, and here the problem is following. We have a system with a lot of measurements, and all of them are noisy. We want to find the feasible regime, satisfying all these measurements and taking into account the accuracy of the sensors. In order to make this problem distributed, we first have to separate the problem into the sub-problems, and every node have the least squares problem, only according to his local measurements. Also, I want to mention that every node have the local copy of state vector V. Let's initialize the algorithm, initialize the initial step size and step decrease rate. And the first step is to compute the local gradient step. The point here that new state vector can be out of the feasibility region. The feasibility region is the upper bound on voltage. And for these out of bounds values, we are making the Euclidean projection to make them feasible. And then these feasible values are broadcast to the neighbors. And every node is averaging his opinion with the opinions of his immediate neighbors by using the weights of the Gaussian matrix Q, which is double stochastic. The last step is to update the step size and check the convergence. If we converge, we have a solution. Otherwise, we continue iterating from step one. The algorithm was tested on different IEEE schemes from 9 to 39 buses, and also we made a lot of tests by setting different type parameters. And you can see two figures with different runs, with different parameter setups, and the graph represents the consensus metric over iterations. This consensus metric can be understood as the norm of disagreement with the average opinion. After that, we are making the extension of this algorithm by using the heavy ball algorithm. It changes the local gradient step by a new term, the momentum term, and this increases the performance of the algorithm because it reaches a better solution in less number of iterations, and it significantly reduces the number of iterations. Let me proceed with the second algorithm. It is the AC optimal power flow. Here the problem is following. We have the system with predefined demand. We know the plant capabilities. We know the thermal limit of lines. And we want to find the feasible dispatch with minimal cost of generation. In order to make this problem distributed, we first go to the system and separate it into the subsystems. Every node their local system with copies of his immediate neighbors. Every local subsystem have its own optimal power flow problem, which is not convex. We want to make it convex. That's why we are using SDP relaxation for it. The trick is following. We are substituting the VV transpose by W, which have to be positive semi-definite and have rank 1. Let's start the algorithm. We are using the ADMM algorithm and we are initializing all the multipliers. Then, the first step is to solve local OPF problem. Here, the objective is having two terms. The first term is cost function for the cost function for generator nodes, and the second part for every node, the augmented Lagrangian part. The goal of the augmented Lagrangian part is to coordinate the solutions of the subsystems and also the absolute zero in all of the augmented Lagrangian parts in all subsystems ensure the satisfaction of global power balance equation. The goal of the augmented Lagrangian part is to equalize the power, the Calendar flows, the information on Calendar flows between the neighbors. And here you can see the variable AX with their sums and subtractions of the power flows. And after the solving of the local problem, these messages are broadcasted to the immediate neighbors. And here you can see all the messages available in the system. They are separated to sums and subtractions in order to update the Z. We update the Z by averaging these messages. After we obtain new Z and solve the local problem, we want to update the first Lagrangian multiplier by using the results of the local OPF AX, the updated Z, and as a step size, we are using the second Lagrangian multiplier, rho. Then we want to update the rho. In order to do that, we first have to calculate the local gap. And if the local gap is decreasing with acceptance rates gamma, we do not change it, otherwise we multiply it by tau. After that, we are sending all the rows to immediate neighbors, and every node is choosing the maximum row with corresponding neighbor. The last step is to check convergence. If the sum of local gaps is less than epsilon, we have the solution. Otherwise, we continue iterating from the step 1. We carried out an extensive analysis on hyperparameter sensitivity, and here you can see two runs of the test, and they are pretty similar in terms of cost function, in terms of cost of generation, and they are pretty close to the optimal centralized solution. They are almost the same in terms of dispatch too, but the second run is 8 times faster, and this is why these algorithms are very sensitive to initial parameters. I showed you the implementation of the ADMM OPF and state estimation, distributed state estimation. And now I want to continue with the incorporated solution, show how these algorithms can augment each other. And there are cases when the SDP relaxation for the OPF problem work inexact, and that means that in our case, it means that reactive power balance equation is unsatisfied. And in this case, we want to adjust the solution of the OPF by using this distributed state estimation. In order to do that, we take the local output of the optimal power flow and set it as an input for the state estimation. As we know the source of issue, the generated reactive power, we set high sigma for these measurements, and this allows the algorithm relax on these measurements and obtain new feasible solution. After running this distributed heavy ball algorithm, we are obtaining new feasible solution satisfying all of the technical constraints, and this solution is optimal in terms of cost of generation. I want to mention that this result is similar to centralized power flow. To conclude, I want to say that distributed solutions can reach almost optimal result with less than 1% error, and we do respect privacy of data because we do not share any of the crucial information between the nodes. And I also show that distributed solutions can augment each other and make overall performance much better. In the end, I want to mention that this was the work in collaboration with Politecnica di Torino, and the results of this work are reported for the conference PowerTech, and it was a nice conversation. I think in this case we can understand what are these areas and use integrated solutions in terms of distributed and decentralized by separating this area, and because probably in this case this area will be in consensus without another part, and it can lead to the overall consensus. Maybe it will be the a good solution. Or I misunderstood your question.
If maybe a large part of the grid is in consensus, could we be aware that we have estimated the state of this line? Or when it will come to consensus with another part, we may have the.
Okay, I think the point here is the stopping criteria. When we are stopping the algorithm, it is a very good point because we consider the global stopping criteria, and it is a very weak point in all of the works nowadays. And I feel it like the field of the further research to understand how we can stop this to solve this issue what you are talking about. Yes.
You know, in a distributed power system, I think there are different tasks to be solved. You mentioned optimal power flow and safety estimation and so on, but there are different tasks. What do you think about it, and do we need to solve the recent task you mentioned about more, or we need something else? Is it enough for a new kind, new generation of power?
I do not think that it is enough because there is no market in my implementation, and the market is one of the most crucial parts of the distributed systems, because all this work is done to implement the market. And this is the first crucial thing. And after that, when, for example, why the frequency control is very crucial? Because if we do not have a centralized system operator with a lot of vendors like in the USA, it's pretty tricky to control. And if everyone would have the universal one algorithm, it would be easier.
But what is the norm?
What is the norm?
No,
what
is the norm? In the grid, what is the norm?
No, bus.
Bus, no.
No, area.
What is the norm? You said.
Yes. I understand. I did not make an analysis of what can be the node, but we take the actual ESKIM, so the substation or the big plant with the generation is the node, the substation is the node, and the demand is the node.
So it is not electrical node, it is such as an area, substation or a power station?
I think yes.
But not easy. But not easy.
It can be implemented in different ways. So, for example, we can talk about the aggregated node, and if this algorithm will work, we can talk about the electrical node in the smaller system, for example, in microgrid, and it also will work. So, it don't really depend on the mathematics. Don't really depend on what to consider as a node.
Yes, but then this is related to scalability, in fact, of your approach. Because what you're doing is somehow constraining. And if you have a network, as we do in physics, we would do, let's say, renormalization. We would do some constraining, let's say. And this question of node is central because it relates also to the accuracy of your
graphs. On the figures, I saw that on the bigger schemes, the algorithm works worse. And it is, I understand why it is going on. And the further research is to test this algorithm to on bigger networks from 100 buses and understand how we can change the broadcasting of information. Probably two hop sending of information will decrease the number of iterations, because now we can see that only one hop from immediate neighbor to immediate neighbor, and probably two hops will do the situation better.
Yes, but you can say optimize both. Let's say the quantity of information that you can transmit, and let's say the quality of the results that you obtain from your approach. It's a trade-off between complexity and accuracy.
Yes, and this is a good point to understand what will be trade-off for different systems, because for now the algorithm is implemented and tested on less schemes, and it is the next step to understand the growth with the real system, not real, but mini systems.
I have two questions. So the first one is related to the parameters of your handball methods.
Yes.
So you know this, well, you already know that this is very sensitive for,
yes,
for the parameter that you are choosing. So my question is like, so do you have a systematic way of computing those parameters for your specific problem, or do you need to solve the problem several times and then you decide, well, this is now the parameters?
Yes. Talking about the parameters of the gradient descent and heavy ball, there is a theoretical basis on it, how to choose the alpha, the initial alpha, and if our function is convex and differentiable and it is Lipschitz continuous with the Lipschitz constant greater than zero, so if we choose the alpha step size, the f is convex and differentiable, and also it is Lipschitz continuous with Lipschitz constant this one, so this is the k iteration and the optimal value. Alpha, and if we choose it like this, we can guarantee that the convergence of the algorithm will be with complexity O this, and if we choose the right epsilon, we can, in the worst case, guarantee that the convergence will be 1 over epsilon. It is about the...
this epsilon there?
The quality of the solution. Ah, epsilon, yes. How far the solution is from the optimum? When we stop, the stopping criteria, if we choose this stopping criteria, not another one.
Yeah, so this is the theoretical one.
Yes, this is the theoretical basis, and of course it do not work for the non-convex function, and we have to think how to automatize it, because probably it depends on the size of the system, and I can say that for schemes I tested it, the 10 in minus 10, times minus 10 works good for all the schemes, but additional tuning may perform do the recommendations for it, and that's it.
Okay, in practice, you choose like this, like you mentioned. So
yeah,
you're right. Testing different parameters. Okay, and the other question is more related with the motivation of the work. So, if you have a good motivation of this distributed optimization, it's a very common in many fields. I feel like when you come back to the power system that you are applying that, so usually this center is quite skeptical of these approaches and conservative.
Yes.
And one of the reasons is like, well, we have a system operator who's in charge of doing this optimal dispatch, and it and this is responsible, so it has some legal action if something is going wrong. So this is kind of the first statement for my question. So it's kind of two questions. The first one is how can you convince system operator or market council, someone higher authorities, just to use this kind of approaches? And the other one is like is related with this, is like, are you willing to, if you are generating plan, manual generating plan, are you willing to share information? Do you prefer to share information with another generating plan, with your neighbor, or do you prefer to share information with the system operator? Which leads in the centralized and classical ways.
Thank you for your questions. I will start from the first. In Russia, yes, the system operator is centralized, and it is no need for distributed methods because all the information is shared only with the system operator and everything is okay. But in the USA, there are different system operators and all different vendors, and plants do not want to share information. So probably they want to share information with one system operating, but don't want to with another. So it depends. And in this USA situation, it's probably better to use the distributed and decentralized methods because of their consumption they are using, because of the market they are using. And probably would potentially can be useful in Russia when Russian energy market would have the multi-vendor system. Talking about your second question, it was.
Do you prefer to share information?
Yes.
Do you prefer to share information with your neighbors?
You can share information with system operator by sending email or whatever. And here you will not share information. You just solve locally and then share some non-sufficient constants, variables that can be reverse engineered, but everything in our world can be reverse engineered. So in this case, you do not share information. You just solve it. Stopping criteria of these distributed methods because